अस्सलाम वालेकुम। आवर टुडेज क्लास इज रिगार्डिंग फीदरिंग टेक्निक। देर आर द थ्री आर फोर डिफरेंट नेम्स ऑफ द फीदरिंग टेक्निक। वी आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड पीलिंग टेक्निक एंड कर्व फिटिंग टेक्निक, कर्व स्ट्रिपिंग टेक्निक्स। देर आर फोर और फाइव नेम्स ऑफ दिस टेक्निक एंड वी आर यूजिंग द वर्ड फीदरिंग टेक्निक। Before starting the feathering technique, we will discuss some our previous experiences. In our previous classes, we have already taken the knowledge of IV injections. In the IV injections, we have only one line. That line showed elimination. But when we are discussing oral data, oral lines, then we have the two different lines. One is absorption and other is the elimination. I will make some comparison first here. In our previous, we checked this and now we are moving toward this. This is the basic difference of the feathering technique, peeling technique, curve fitting technique, stripping technique. These are all the four common names of this technique. In this case, we have calculated so many parameters. In our start, we calculated AUC in our labs. Then we calculate rate constant. Then we calculate half-life. Then we can calculate its VD. Then we can calculate its clearance. When I will teach all of you the clearance, then we will same using the same graphical presentation, and we will check the clearance from this data. Now we are moving toward this. This curve, these are basically two curves, two lines. One line is absorption line, and other line is elimination line. In this case, there was only elimination rate constant that was written by K, and which is equal to KE. But here there are the two rate constant. One is KE, and other is KA, absorption rate constant. Remember, we are now till now on the one compartment concept. Till now we have only one fit, no any distribution in both of the graphical presentations. If there is a distribution, then we can make this graph just like this one. Here another concept. One is KE, here is KE, and that will give us the KD, distribution rate constant. And we can make this the same with the passage of this way. Now we have three lines here: absorption line, distribution line, elimination line. In this case, we have distribution line and elimination line. Here we have absorption line and elimination line. Here is elimination line. So by using this, we have our idea. We can calculate rate constant, we can calculate half-life elimination, and by using this, we can calculate elimination rate constant, absorption rate constant, elimination half-life, absorption half-life, AUC, and other parameters. In this case, we can calculate elimination rate constant, elimination half-life, distribution rate constant, distribution half-life, absorption rate constant, distribution rate constant, elimination rate constant, absorption half-life, distribution half-life, and elimination half-life. Okay, where is feathering? Feathering is, now we are taking some extrapolation. We are taking some calculations of this, because when we use this line, these are basically, these two lines are the same. This elimination line and this part of this elimination line, these are basically same. Why these are same? Because they are showing, giving us the data of the decrease from higher to lower concentration. Why these are same? Because this is the data which is actually present in the plasma. These are same because they have the same composition. We are assuming that concentration is decreasing from plasma towards, due to their elimination, due to their biotransformation, due to their excretion. So we can assume that concentration is lowering from this to this. But when we taking the oral dosiform or intramuscular dosiform, then we have some increased concentration in plasma. Now these are the parameters of our increase one. And increased concentration, for example, at zero time, we have no any concentration of the drug. At 1 hour, we have, for example, 2. And at 2 hours, concentration is this one. At 4 hours, concentration once again increased. And at 6 hours, we got the maximum concentration. That concentration is Cmax, maximum concentration, which we obtained by where we have elimination and absorption at the equilibrium. Then concentration is decreasing and we are moving down. This concentration is giving us the concept of elimination at 8 hours. Now concentration decrease. Then at 10 hours, concentration more decrease. And then at 12 hours, we have got another decrease in the concentration. So our concept is, we can make so many sentences on this line. Elimination. What are these sentences? We want to take the half-life, okay? Take the two exact points which are exactly half of the each other and check the difference of the time. That time will be the half-life, okay? From this line, if we want to take the rate constant, take the difference of the natural log of those two concentrations and divide with the difference of the time, then we can say, okay, this is the rate constant. Same way, we can have the area under the curve and other things. But in this case, I will draw it first once again, this for the feeding technique. We will convert this absorption line into just like the elimination line. Remember, why we are doing this? We are doing this because we have learned a single method of the elimination. We have learned so many things from this line. So we want this line should be just like this one. This is our conversion. This is our way of learning, way of conversion, this absorption, just like the elimination. If we convert this line, which is giving us the increased concentration, which is giving us the absorption concept, then we can change, we can make it into the elimination-like curve. Then we will be very happy to using the same formula which we are using in the elimination. So our first target is to convert this absorption line just like into elimination line. For this conversion, we will learn the technique which is called feeding technique, which is called curve fitting technique, which is called curve stripping technique, which is called peeling technique. Okay, how we can do this? For example, we have now, this is our okay, this is our curve of our data, which we made on the semi-log graph, and we are understanding this is absorption phase, this is elimination phase, and we have this area, this is plasma concentration, units are microgram per ml, milligram per liter, gram per liter, ppm, ppb, percentage weight by volume, and the on x-axis, that is time, units are in hour. Okay, we will increase this concept this way. We will take a scale and make a straight line from this line towards the y-axis, and these dots, these points are basically called feathered point. These are not the actual points. These are hypothetical points, assumptionary points. We are considering that if we extrapolate this elimination phase towards the y-axis, we got these feathered points, dotted points, and from these feathered points, we will get the difference of this absorption area, and this absorption area will give us another line. That line will be just like the elimination line, but that was actually the absorption. We will perform it, for example, by taking the data. For example, we will make a table. First, for example, we know we have two types of the data. One is time, and other is the concentration. units of time is hour and units of concentration are microgram per minute. Okay, I will make the same graph, same values and the data. For example, at zero time, we have at time zero, we have unknown concentration. We will make on the after extrapolation, and at 2 hour, we have the concentration of for example, we have a graph 1, okay, 10, and then it's 100, then it's 1000. I have made how many cycle graph? 1, 2, 3 cycle graph. And start from the 1 because it's semi-log graph. Okay, from the semi-log graph, I calculate this at 2 hour. My concentration is at 2 hour, concentration of the drug is, for example, 3 microgram. Okay, as we increase the time, we have the concentration at 4 hour, concentration was 8 microgram per mL. And at 6 hour, concentration was 10 microgram per mL. As we move forward, concentration of at 8 hour, concentration was say 80 microgram per mL. And then at 10 hour, concentration was 100 microgram. I will write here, at 2 hour concentration was 3 microgram per ml, at 4 hour concentration was 8 microgram per ml, then at 10 hour, and then 6 hour concentration was 10 microgram per ml, and as we move next, at 8 hour that concentration is 80 microgram per ml, and at 10 hour the concentration is 100 microgram per ml. Now it's a maximum. Now we are moving towards the down because we are getting the elimination of the drug. At this point, we will assume that these concentrations are, as time in 12 hours, concentration is reduced to, for example, 90, okay? At 12 hours, concentration is 90. And at 16 hours, concentration was 50, okay? At 16 hour its concentration is 50. Then as we move towards the at 18 hours concentration was 12, and then at 24 hour concentration was 9. Okay, this data is little bit different from the IV. Why it's different? Because we are taking some increase in the concentration till at 10 hour. At 10 hour, that concentration is the maximum. Okay, at this point, we will say this concentration is Cmax and this time is Tmax. Maximum time at which the concentration of drug is present, that is Tmax. Maximum of concentration that is present in the, concentration which is present at the Tmax is Cmax. So, at 10 hour, we have the 100 microgram per ml. These are our concentrations. Okay, now we can easily differentiate between that area which is giving us the absorption and that area which is giving us the elimination. It means at from 0 to 10 hours, we are getting the data of the absorption. And from 10 to 24 hour, we are getting the values of the elimination. So, when we want to calculate the values from the elimination area, means this line, we have the same formulas. We will use the word Ke, elimination rate constant. We will use the elimination half-life word, T half. We will use the same formulas for the K and the T half, 0.693 over Ke, and same ln C2 minus ln C1 over T2 minus T1. These are the same. But where is the difference? Difference is, we have extrapolated these points, and now we will write the extrapolated points. These are the extrapolated points. For example, this concentration is 110, okay, this concentration is 150, and this concentration is, sorry, it's 200, for example, say, it's 400, okay, now it's 800 concentrations, extrapolated concentration. We have marked and we have a time Now we have the same time frame. For example, when we take the difference of this, for example, I have this feeder point and I will check this. This is my actual point. Now at 6 hour, my concentration is 400, which is feeder. I will write the feathered concentration. At 6 hour, we have the concentration of 400, which is feathered, not actual, hypothetical. Okay, then what will be happen at 8 hour? Okay, this one. And this is the concentration which is 300, okay. At 8 hour, this concentration is 300 microgram per ml. Now, what will be at 2 hours? At 2 hours, this concentration is near to, it's 700. Okay, we'll write here 700. And maximum is 800. These are our feathered concentrations. And at 8 hour, that concentration is, we have already written, sorry, it's at 8 hour, that concentration is 300. And at 4 hour, sorry, at 4 hour, this concentration is, okay, 500. 800 is the maximum, which is called Cp naught, which is actually coincide with the y-axis, maximum, okay. 700 is the concentration, which is feathered concentration at time 2 hours, which was actual 3. Then, at time 4 hour, that our feathered concentration is 500, and actual was 8. But at 6 hour, feathered concentration is 400, actual was 10. Same case, at 8 hours, feathered is 300 and actual was 80. Now, what will we do? We will take the subtraction. We will minus, we will getting the minus from these points to these points. We will have the values of this. For example, first one is 800, okay. Then 697, then 492. Then 390. Then 220. Now we have these values. 800, 692, 492. Remember, these are just like the elimination values. Higher, then lower, then lower, then the lowest. Okay, we will make another line. We can make the same line here. But this is now some like the complex. I will choose another scale on the same graph, because we have a very plenty of space on the left side, on the top of the right. Then we can make another scale. Okay, why we are choosing this scale? We have the time frame. Okay, 0 time, 2 hour, 4 hour, 6 hour, and 8 hours only. And now our concentrations are started from the 220. Now we will start our scale from 100, then it's 1000, then it's 10,000. We will make these points and make this straight line. This is actually just like the elimination. This is just like this absorption is now converting into this one. We have converted this increasing data into the decreasing data. We have converted this absorption data just like the elimination data. So, as we convert this data just like the elimination, now we have an opportunity to use the same formulas. For example, I want to calculate the Ka, absorption rate constant. Then my formula would be Ka is equal to ln C2 minus ln C1 over T2 minus T1. Same formula, just like the Ke, but the curve is different. Here is the curve, this one for the Ke. And this curve is now just like the elimination, and this is Ka. Say, if we want to calculate the half-life, T half A, absorption half-life, Very simple formula, 0.693 over Ka. If we want to check the AUC separate, then we can check. If we want to check the clearance, if we want to check the different data. In our next lab, we will give you a data for every group, for the different data. You will have to apply the feeder technique. You will have to calculate the sum pharmacokinetic parameters which should be mentioned in the in their questions. And by performing this type of the experiment, we will you will have to make three types of the values. One is your calculations to calculate the half-life, rate constant, AUC, blah blah blah. And these are the our data in the form of table. And now this graph, these three scan, you will upload it in your lab area. Different groups, different data, different answers, and we will check it and assume that you are doing the good work in your homes. If you have any questions regarding this lab, you may ask me in my YouTube videos and also on the LMS data. Thank you very much.